Hey guys, it's Vincent with Vasco Toys. On today's episode of Action Vasco, I have a castle diorama to show you guys that I made from Mythic Legions and other 6-inch fantasy figures.
Vasco Toys. Action figure dioramas and props.
So the dimensions for this diorama are about 17 and a half inches across on the base, 10 inches deep, and about 13 inches tall on this piece. And this is a four-piece diorama. So we have the base piece, then we have the wall piece right here, which is fully magnetized. And then the final thing is the two doors, which are on functioning hinges and can come off, can be removed. I want to take a look at each individual piece on its own so I can kind of explain what I did with some of these. So this part of the dial might be my favorite part, although I really like this dial because I've never done a terrain and architectural type diorama together before, a hybrid of those two styles. So I really have been wanting to try that, and I felt like a Mythic Legions type piece would really make sense to do something like that. So the first thing I want to cover on this diorama is there's basically three different components to this that I'm using in terms of materials. The first is, of course, the foam board that I use, the XPS insulation foam board, the pink foam that I always use. That's the base of this, and it's also some of the rocks that you see. So I've got some of them that you're seeing here. All of the bigger pieces are insulation foam carved to look like rocks, and then there are some smaller ones too that I'm pointing out. Then I went to the aquarium rocks, and I tried to scatter those kind of around where I thought they should be, just based on where the building was going to be and where I had the magnets. I wanted the rocks to kind of form around those pillars. And then I wanted to try to have them appear somewhat more naturally than what I've done before. And my idea was that this was sort of a loosely defined path, like a this is the path to get to the gate when that's installed there. And then the rest of this is kind of not touched as much. So that's why there's this more of this textured feel to it. And that is actually some sand that I had gotten. I actually had someone had it left over at work and didn't want it, and I volunteered to take it off their hands because I knew I could put it to use. So basically what I did was I put down the first I carved the foam, then I textured it with tin foil, then I carved up the rocks, placed them where I wanted to, hot glued them in place. Then what I did was I put Mod Podge down on the whole thing where I wanted the sort of the looser gravel kind of a feel to be, and I sprinkled all that sand that I was talking about. And after that was done, I sprayed that with my Mod Podge water solution using just a spray bottle from the dollar store. And I went and installed the aquarium rocks, and I used hot glue to put those in. And I really liked the way that that all came out. Then one other thing I wanted to mention too before I talk about the paint is the dead grass effect that I kind of have going on, and it's like a dead grass or a weeds kind of a effect. And I want to give credit to my friend Terraformer, who kind of told me what to do there. And it's funny enough, all this is cut up broom, like from like a natural straw kind of broom, cut up I don't know, pieces of the broom. And then I just use some, I think it's Hot Wire Factory Styro Glue, to glue all of that in into where I thought it would be, like coming up through the cracks of some of the rocks and things like that. So I was really excited about that because I think, at first I wasn't sure how sparse I wanted it to be or how full, and I decided to go with kind of less is more look, just have some of it for a first attempt, and I think it came out well. So with the paint for this, I'm really proud of the way this came out, and really all I did was what I showed in my flocking tutorial, and I'll link to that in the upper right hand corner so you guys can see it. But basically, I painted the entire thing just a base brown, and then after that dried, I went in with a watered down white and dabbed that throughout the piece, and that was including on the rocks. Then I took a mixed, like a goldish brown kind of color, and I did that as well throughout, just where I thought it would make sense. And then after that, I did several brown washes with the original base color, and I did two or three of them. And after that was done, I was feeling good about, you know, the color variations that were showing up, but I didn't think it was blended the way that I wanted throughout the piece, especially on the rocks. I felt like the rocks didn't look like they stood out enough. So then I took a lighter tan, and I dry brushed all the rocks individually, all the big rocks, and also the pieces, the smaller aquarium rocks. And that was starting to look a lot better, and I really thought that that was looking good. So then I also just kind of thought, let me do around the perimeter of where those rocks are sitting and dry brush that area as well. So that was really how I painted this base piece. And like I said, really proud of the base piece. And now I'm going to show you guys the architectural structure as well. For the architectural castle portion of this build, I wanted to start out by shouting out one of my good friends in the diorama community. His name's Josh. He goes by SageJDG on Instagram. And Josh is one of the most incredible diorama artists that I've seen, one of my personal favorites, somebody that I've been fortunate to meet in person and become friends with over the years. And he has just the most spectacular dioramas when it comes to a lot of different types, whether it's a cityscape or medieval fantasy or landscape. He does every kind of thing. But one of the things that always catches my attention with him is his sort of like his castles and his brickwork and just the things that he does that fits in with Mythic Legions. So I was inspired by him to get into collecting Mythic Legions at all, but definitely when it comes to the diorama creation process for Mythic Legions. So I wanted to give him some credit before we get into this. And he also helped me out a little bit with some just brainstorming for the piece. So I'm going to show you guys, this is not a 360 finish at this point. It has the front, and the each side has, like, this is the look of the sides. Right now the back is not finished. This is not how it's going to look when it goes out. It's going to be painted the base gray color in the back, just so you're not going to see any pink, and the doors will be painted the base brown color. But just wanted you guys to see. So the other side looks the same as this side in terms of the design choice. And with something like this is made a lot easier, you know, for me with when I use my procs on, because then I'm able to just make sure that all of these kind of pieces are exactly the same length and width that I need them to be, and repeatable and all that kind of thing, especially these sorts of things. Those are really, really difficult to do by hand. But I will say, Josh, who I mentioned, does not use a Proxon. He does all of his stuff by hand, which is incredible. So kudos to him for that. Extremely talented when it comes to just using the knife and in general. But for this piece, everything is made out of XPS foam that you see here, with the exception of the door handles, which these knockers actually do, like, swing, and then the metal reinforcer pieces that I have on the door. Those are 3D printed, custom designed by me. And then the only other thing on here that's not foam is the rounded button part of the decorative part of the facade here. And all those are the little sticky, like half pearls that you can get at the dollar store. I love using those, so I get them whenever I can. I have them in several different sizes. And at first I was going to 3D print these, and then I realized I could just cut some squares made out of foam with the Procs on, glue some of those pearl pieces on, and then have something that would look very similar to what I was going to design anyway in 3D print. So I think that they came out well, and sometimes I get 3D print happy when I don't need to. So it's sometimes it's nice to come up with a solution that is not 3D printer based, if I can find it, just because it saves time and design time as well. But for this diorama, it's all hot glued together, and it's basically the back piece is the entire width of the building. There's a 1-inch foam, and then I use 2-inch foam pieces here that I cut down to size. So this is each pillar has 1, 2, 3 separate pieces glued on top of each other. This is just trim work, so it just goes around. But this piece is sitting on some skinny foam from the dollar store, and then the top part is skinny foam as well. So I used a couple different kinds of foam just to make it easier on myself, and I really think it came out, you know, pretty cool. For the paintwork, I'm going to cover the doors separately, but for the castle part of it, it was pretty simple. I used an Anita's Heather Gray as the base coat. So I base coated this in gray because I knew I was going to paint it a light color, and I wouldn't, if I base coated it black, it would have taken 2 or 3 coats of the Heather Gray to take before that would have showed up over top of the black. So I just went directly on the pink with the Heather Gray and did that across the whole thing. Then after that was done, I did some dry brushing with an earth brown, which is the same base coat that I use on the base landscaping piece. And I did that where I thought, you know, dirt would have accumulated kind of along these areas and, you know, up in the areas where the architecture kind of is happening. And then after that was done, I did my black wash, which is black paint, brown, green, water, Dawn dish detergent, and I just covered the entire thing with it, and that made it look a little bit more weathered, a little bit more older, and along with it highlighted the dry brushing. So that is the castle portion of this. Now we're going to take a look at the doors. These doors are functional. So basically they're on hinges that I 3D printed, and they only open inward, and that's because of the design of the door. See, these pieces that I put here, which this door is made out of foam, prevent this door from being able to swing in or out. It only swings in. And I think that kind of makes sense too, like if this was a fortress or a castle, you know, the people inside are going to be choosing if they're opening it, and I don't know, just it made sense to me to have that happen. So I'm going to flip this around so you guys can see how to take the doors off the hinges and put them back. The way this is built, you have to push the doors in order to take them off the hinges properly. So I'm going to turn this around, make sure you guys have a good view of this. Okay. So, real quick, I'm going to just show you guys. So the door hinges are two different pieces. They're like this, this square piece or rectangular piece. And then they also have this piece. So the way I do this is, it's kind of like if you look at a gate, I don't know if you have a gate in your backyard, it basically has these, cylinders that sit inside the rectangles, which are hollowed out with the same size cylinder. And then if you want to put them back in, it's real simple. They both just line up, you push it down, and then you can close the door up. So that's the mechanism for closing the door, which I've used this before on my X-Men gate, so I didn't have to recreate the wheel on this. I just knew that I could apply it. And these are glued with the styro glue from Hot Wire Foam Factory that really bonds plastic very well to foam. So I just make sure I let it sit enough, and then I know I'm gonna have a reliable bond so that I can open the doors on a swivel the way that I want to. So we'll go back to the front here. I mentioned already that, you know, these are PLA 3D printed parts. At this point, I design all of my 3D printed parts in Tinkercad, and then I use a Kingrune KP3 printer, and I usually use Hatchbox filament, and then if I need to, I print in gray, black, or white filament unless it calls for something else, and then I'll either spray paint it or I'll paint it by hand. And because this was supposed to look like an older kind of metal, I just printed them in black, and then I hand dry brushed some silver on top of all of the pieces here. And so, you know, like I think I mentioned that the knockers, they're three different pieces. So this piece, and then the actual knocker itself, and it's just glued together. And then once that piece is glued together, I pop it on there. So for the door itself, it's XPS foam, and you guys saw it's pretty thin. I used my Proxon to cut it, you know, I don't know, maybe a quarter inch. And then I put these pieces on top, hot glued those in place. And when you're doing the door frame, or excuse me, the if you want to do the wood grain, the way that I do it is the way that Terrafoamer taught me to do it. And that's basically you take a wire brush, you dip it in water, and then you really gently go over the top, because you don't want to tear the foam, you just want to texture it. And if you put a lot of pressure and you don't let the brush do the work and you try to force it, you're going to tear the foam, and that's really what not going to give you the wood grain effect that you want. So you just go lightly over it. And then after that's done, with this, I actually just base coat it in the brown, and then I just do my wash over top, and then I take a dry brushing of a tannish color just to make it look like it's weathered or aged, and there's different color variation in there. So I mentioned at the beginning of this video, the reason that I made this was really for Mythic Legions, but I want to show you guys some different lines that I feel like will fit in. I'm going to include Mythic Legions, of course, just because like there's so many different things you can do with fantasy, and these are just based on the figures that I have in my collection, of course. But I am going to start with Mythic Legions, and my favorite Legions figure that I have so far, which is Magnus, and he... I just think he looks so cool. I love him with his with his unhelmeted head or with the full armor on. I think he looks so cool in the diorama here, and I just think, you know, this works so well with Mythic Legions. And I actually did a Mythic Legions diorama not too long ago that I never made a video for. I really wish I would have, because it was one of my favorites that I'd done. But so I had used Magnus in that one as well, but here he is in this new diorama. Next, I'm going to put Geralt of Rivia, and this is by McFarlane, and I'm hoping I can get him to stand in this pose. So Geralt is one of my favorite video game characters, and I don't get to play video games a whole lot anymore, but one of the last games that I played almost the whole way through was The Witcher 3, and of course I love the Netflix show, and as soon as I knew that this figure was coming out, I had to get it. This is the only McFarlane figure that I currently have in my collection at the time of taping this video. So there's Geralt. And then I also recently picked up the He-Man Revelations figure from the Netflix show, because I just thought he looked so cool, and I wanted to make sure that I could do some He-Man stuff, because I've really never done He-Man stuff. And although this is not, you know, Castle Grayskull, it still makes sense for He-Man to be in front of something like this, and I think he looks pretty good in there. And last that I'm going to show you is another Legions figure, but I just think he's real cool, and I wanted to give you guys. These are the only two, Magnus and Baron Volgar, who I have here, are the only two Mythic Legions figures that I have at this point. I have a bunch on pre-order, but I just got into this line this year. So I should say in 2020. And I should say, you know, like it's one of my favorites so far, and I'm really looking forward to what I'm going to be able to do when I get some other figures. I have gladiators, skeletons, all kinds of stuff that are going to be coming at my way, hopefully in the near future. Thank you guys so much for checking out this castle diorama that we showed in this episode. Really excited about this piece, and I hope you guys liked it. If you did like the video, please hit the thumbs up, and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't. We're going to have a lot more videos like this. We also do tutorials. We also do some live stream stuff, and we do some tip videos. So if you think that any of those might be interesting, please go ahead and subscribe, hit the bell notification so we can see you in the next episode.